Father, although we cannot imagine the intensity of his suffering, we claim your promise, dear Lord. For you say, the Lord is close to the broken heart, and he saves those who are crushed in spirit. From your word, we believe your great and your tender mercy. We're dear to the God, and that your saving power will always be present with you. We cling to the hope that is now surrounded by your healing and loving presence. We claim that we hold dear to the claim, Heavenly Father, that you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, and there will be no more death, or no more mourning or crying or pain. For the former things have all passed away. As we congregate here together, Heavenly Father, help us to celebrate the memory of our brother and to be thankful for his life among us. Bring us, Heavenly Father, bring to our minds his unique personality, his accomplishments, his dreams, and the ordinary blessings of his time spent with us. It is in Jesus' name that we pray.
Prepared for this day. His family will always remember him and all the things that they did as a sign angel. In the street will always remember him as Little Jug. The family loved him as both, and they greatly appreciate the 16 years of his life that they got to enjoy. The good, the bad, the ugly, and the unknown. We come to celebrate the time that we had with him during those 16 years that he was with us and blessed us, that each and everyone had a chance to get to know him.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies. He anoints my head with oil, my cup running over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Doing it. Do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If that were not so, would have told you, because I'm going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I'm coming again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you also will be, and you know the way where I am going.
Now we have a period of time where if any family or friends would like to make remarks, we'd ask you to try to limit it to 2 minutes, but if anyone would like to make some remarks, now is the time. In what? She's coming up? Okay.
Hi, Mrs. Miller wanted me to talk a little bit about Leon. I first met them when they first moved here after Hurricane Katrina. I wrote it down because I want each one of you to know the Leon that I knew. I was not sure, and I'm still not sure what exactly it is that I need to say. I mean, what can I do when there is nothing that will take away the hurt that the Miller family is going through right now? So I'm going to focus on what I do know. I do not remember the date and time that Leon Miller, Cavanti, Noel, and Ruth walked into our school. But I do remember seeing him in the front office at Boyd Elementary. And I remember the smile that he had that day. A smile that will forever be etched in my heart because of how, when he smiled, it will light up a whole room. The Leon that I knew was happy, compassionate, loved to smile, and always had a tender heart for those in need. Today, we gather to celebrate a life that brought joy to so many, a young man that took joy in the hopes, dreams, and accomplishments of others. Leon loved his parents and his siblings. He will always talk to me about how proud he was of them. And he loved his mama. When Mrs. Miller came to Texas for a new start, she taught her children three things that to this day she continues to do. She taught them to help those in need. She taught them to love others. And she always told them to pray. Leon left Boyd a few years ago. However, through the unspoken work that him and his siblings do, he remained and will always remain a part of my life. There's things you don't know about Leon. Leon and his siblings are passionate about collecting toys for the needy, doing food drives, and helping people who lost everything. However, he never talked about his work, but he was very proud of those accomplishments. It is my hope that his brothers and sisters and family continue that legacy in his honor. It is my hope that his friends adopt this belief and join in this legacy as well. It is my hope that his siblings and friends know that if they need any help from someone, they can reach out to this community and that we are here for each one of you. Every human life is unique and valuable. No one deserves to be remembered simply for a single decision, however flawed. Sadly, sometimes outside forces in the world overcome understanding and lead to drastic consequences. But what I want you each to remember is that no matter how challenging your loved one's life may have been, Leon's life held moments of joy, friendship, achievement, giving, and happiness. And that deserves to be remembered. So he should be remembered for the life that he lived in all its richness. If there is any counsel that I can offer to all who gather and grieve here today, is to remember that the best way to honor Leon is by remembering his compassion for others and his smile. His legacy will not be how he died, but rather how he lived and how deeply he loved those around him.
Any others that would like to make a remark?
To the Miller family, I want you to know your son was a blessing to Rockbridge. Very mannerable, very respectful, hardworking, did anything you asked him to do. They had that playful moment, and we would get after them, and they would say, "Yes, ma'am." If you ask them to change seats, they never question. They say, "Yes, ma'am." If you ever needed help, they were there. And it's so hard to find teenagers to help, to do something, and they're not getting paid for it. But they were there. And I want you to know they are loved. And I want you to know, you guys, we don't come into the world with instruction books on how to raise our kids. That's not there. You learn as you go. And all I have to say to parents, be strong. Look at the good things that your child has left you with, the good memories. And as I can see from here, they left us with a lot of memories, a lot of fun things we can think about and laugh about. I see faces from my school district, and I work for Plano, that are here that knew your son. So I'm going to end with this. We love him very much, and it won't stop.
Any others? Okay, we now have a solo song. Oh, we do have someone.
How y'all doing? Doing good. I don't even really know what to say on some stuff, like, you know what I'm saying? I'm really lost the words. Like, this right here coming up here, you know what I'm saying? It was hard for me to do because y'all already could tell in my voice that, you know what I'm saying? But, like, Ms. Miller, I'm sorry, you know? I'm sorry for y'all. Leon is like a brother, Noel. I wipe your tears, bro. You a soldier, fam. Your brother was a soldier, too, fam. You feel me? Like, I'm here, bro. I'm not going to be your big brother, but you know I'm here, fam. I'm like your big brother. You feel me? I love y'all, bro. Like, real talk. Drake, keep your head up. Kevontae, keep your head up. Ball, keep your head up, bro. I love y'all. Like I said, I don't really know what to say because I'm really lost the words. Like, Leon, he was cool, you know? Ain't nobody really deserve this. Lael, keep your head up. Like, you feel me? I know what you're going through. I done been there before. I love y'all, man. This real too sharp, bro. I love y'all.
How y'all doing? I just want to say thank y'all for coming out, family and friends. I'm sorry. I love y'all. Y'all know I love y'all. This really taking a lot out of me. For real. You gotta make the memories now. You got to make the memories now. I want to be a part of that. I want our whole family to come together. I miss y'all. I love y'all. I want y'all to hold on to the ones y'all love the most. Please do. Because you don't never know what somebody going through. I just want to say I really love y'all. I thank everybody for coming. Family and friends, y'all might not know me, but I'm his cousin. And I just love all of y'all. The little family that we got, we need to hold on to that. Y'all know what I'm talking about. We need to hold on to that. I really love y'all and thank all y'all for coming. Thank y'all.
Hi, thank y'all for coming. Okay, I just want to thank my mom and my dad because they're the best parents. They're the best parents. They're the best parents. And I just want to thank y'all for coming. And I want to thank y'all for having my brother because y'all know that was my dog. And I just want to say to Leon that I love you and that we're going to miss you, but we're going to be strong for you because you are strong. And everybody that know you are strong. And you stand on all tier. And I don't want nobody to be sad or feel hurt because at the end of the day, we're going to still smile and we're going to still stand tall because that's what he would want us to do. He wouldn't want us to be sad. He'll laugh at you if you crying. So don't cry, wipe your tears, because we good. We gonna be good. It's just another one that gotta go home. We all gotta go one day. You just don't know who next. So love those that's there for you, that's there. Make up with your family. Tell them that you love them, because you never know. But I just wanna thank my mom and my dad because they're the best parents that you could ever ask for. And they love you upon 10. Everybody in here that know my mom and daddy love you like you they son, like you they daughter. So I just want to thank y'all because y'all is the real ones. So thank you. And I love y'all. I love y'all.
How y'all doing? I just want to say, it's crazy. Leon was just always there for me when I needed a place to sleep. I was hungry. Always brought me to his house every time. And I want to say thank you to his mommy and dad. They made sure I was straight all the time. when I needed them, they was always there. They ain't never give up on me when I was going through times where I felt like I was giving up. His mama was always there for me. Noah was always there for me. They ain't never stopped loving me, never stopped caring for me. And I just want to say I appreciate all y'all for really coming out. And I just want to say, everybody just keep your head up. And again, just thank y'all for coming out here. I just thank y'all.
We'll now move forward in the program with a solo song by Leonice Caspi.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Leonice, for those who don't know. And I'm going to sing this song for my brother, of course. And I just want to say thanks for everybody who did come, because I know it was a long drive for all of us. But everybody do need to come together at this time. Take me to the King. I don't have much to bring. My heart is torn to pieces. That's my offering. Lay me at your throne. Leave me there alone to gaze upon your glory and sing to you this song. Take me to the King. I don't have much to bring. My heart is torn to pieces. That's my offering. Now that's all I got, y'all. I'm sorry.
Thank y'all. I would love to tell everybody and anybody that my son, Lee, Jug, Leon, whatever you remember him as, if he offended any one of you, if he hurt any one of you, I apologize on his behalf. And if any one of you offended him, or hurt him, I forgive you on his behalf. I truly thank God for 16 years with Lil Leon. Thank you, my handsome king. He represents you. We don't choose destiny. God's will be done. God give everybody a choice. Thank y'all for the tears, but we didn't come here to cry. We didn't come here to cry. I appreciate all the love. So many teachers up in here done wrote Leon up and fussed at him, the detention center. Miss Miller, this boy's in here cutting up, talk to him. The friends, mama, come see. We going through it. Love y'all people. Love y'all people, the good, the bad, and the ugly. Don't let nobody put life labels on your children. Love them. I don't care what nobody say about them. The good, the bad, the ugly, and the unknown. Love them. Learn to love your children. Y'all ain't no perfect people. Y'all sitting up in here, y'all cute. Y'all judge folk, y'all make folk think they unworthy. All of us dirt and filth in God's eyesight. But he merciful and forgiving to all of us. Don't care if we got red bottoms on or a cap from Mimi. This my friend Tamika, she wanted me to look cute for y'all. I wasn't worrying about looking cute, but she wanted me to look cute for y'all. So that's why I got a hat on. I love y'all. The school system, Allen ISD, y'all the best. Y'all the best. The guiding counselors, the teachers, Allen Police Department, y'all the best. I don't see y'all shooting black children, and I know they turning up in these suburbs. I know them. Y'all see them, Jug County. I see them. We need to love each other. Y'all came here today for whatever reason. For whatever reason it was, y'all in here. If you've never been to church before, you're here today. Don't stop. Don't stop. They got a screenshot. If you don't come together to laugh, you will come together to cry. Pick your poison. Pick your poison. Be gentle to people. You never know what people are going through. The parents, the children, the teachers, the officers, be gentle to people. This is not our world. I don't care what you own. God said he owned the cattle upon a thousand hill. All the silver and gold belongs to him. We filthy rags in his eyesight. I don't care if you got knockoff clothes. I don't care if you got the best designer. We all dirt and mud in God's eyesight. We got sinners in here. We got whores in here. We got hypocrites in here. We got adulterers in here. We got racists in here. We got all kind of foolery up in here. And we sitting in here looking for answers. Everybody want to know why my son died. What happened? When you die and you get to meet him, you get to ask him. I love y'all. We come to celebrate. I don't want to judge anybody. I want y'all to love people genuinely. Genuinely. Don't fake for a funeral. Don't get dressed up to give compassion today when people was hurting yesterday. Love people real, real, real. Love people. If they ain't got nothing to give you, if they look like they dirt, love them like you Dove soap. Love them. I don't care what color they is. I don't care what they got going on. Y'all try to make folk feel bad. Y'all don't know what people be going through. Some of y'all children want to kill themselves. They just ain't did it yet. You better pray you be strong like us. You better pray you be strong like us. This is not personal. This is spiritual. God say all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord. I believe y'all love God. I believe we all hurt. I believe we've been carrying the hurt of the world for a long time. But it's time for people to change. You don't have to change for me because everybody got to give account. Every knee going to bow, every tongue going to confess. Not just Lil Leon, not my handsome king, not just me, not just my children. Not just my family, all of us got to give account. Whether you get up from here today and talk about us after you leave, that's fine. We love y'all. We love y'all. But we got to love each other real. God say, love ye one another as I have loved you. Put more love in it. Add some more love to it. Add some more love to it. If it ain't working, add some more love to it. I love y'all. From the heart, Collins County, work with these kids. Work with them. Thank y'all. Thank every child that came. Lil Leon, Renaz, we love y'all. We love y'all. I know who his friends is. Y'all, nobody's fault. No fault game. No fault game. Nobody's fault. There is no answers. When you get to see Leon, if you ever get to see him again, ask him. Don't ask nobody else in my family what happened. Ask him or ask God. Respect me like that. I ain't calling you asking you no questions. Don't call me and ask me no questions. If you want love on me and my children, do that. Do it wholeheartedly and do it sincerely. Not just to me and mine, to everybody. Everybody. That's the golden rule. I love y'all, Rock Bridge Church. Y'all represent God so well. Y'all represent God so well. I remember we were homeless. I remember we were homeless living in Plano at the hotel. What's her name right there? What's your name? Miss Oliver. That was my angel. I always called that lady my angel. We was low, 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 family. And we not mad at nobody because we had to go through everything. But that beautiful queen, Miss Oliver, Boyd Ella, that lady took us. She loved on us. She put jackets on us. Miss Marisol, she worked with my children. I don't know if my best friend Anna in here, but I love her. I love Raven. I love Ryan. I love all y'all. That's all I know how to do. Will, we Beatrice grandchildren. That's all I know how to do. God bless y'all. Thank y'all. And I appreciate everybody. This is a beautiful time. This is a beautiful time. Love on these kids for Lil Leon. If you love Lil Leon, love his friends. Love his friends and love other people's children. If you love Lil Leon, love his friends, love his siblings, and love on other people's children. Ain't nobody perfect. Jill County, I love y'all. Layla, you the queen, baby. Don't think I forgot you. I say the best for last. I love that beautiful girl. That's ours. That's Miller girl. That's Jug. We human out here, y'all. She got my grandbaby. I'm too excited. Lay, you know this Jug County. You thought I forgot you, girl. Could never. Y'all love on these children. She beautiful. She dealt with my son demons. See, people have demons y'all don't know nothing about. Y'all don't know what you're in fighting around here. She loved him enough to deal with his demons. Don't nothing be wrong. People be fighting demons. Don't act like y'all don't fight no demons. People be fighting demons. Everybody ain't strong, Layla, but we strong, Layla. We strong. I love you, queen. I love you. You jug for life, baby. We got you. I love you, queen. God bless y'all. God bless everybody. Trust me. Love your children. Love your neighbor's child. Love somebody's child. Because none of us perfect. God bless you.
Let the church say amen. 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 Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. To the Miller family, we pray that God blesses you, watch over you, and keep you. You know, I just remember Leon coming up, and I would always just mess with him about he can't play basketball. I kept bothering about him, and Noel, I tell him I'll take you both on at the same time. I just wanted to bother with him, but we're here. We want to give a celebration time. As Ms. Miller said, we want to celebrate Leon's homegoing. So we're going to do that here in a moment. But I want to take with you, if you would go with me to John chapter 14. We're going to look at 6 verses of scripture in the 14th chapter of John. I'm going to read those to you. And then I'm going to talk to you just a few minutes about the promises of heaven. So I'm going to give you a little bit about the promises of heaven. And it's John chapter 14. I'll set you up some context here. We all have the disciples. They're getting ready. And Jesus had been meeting with them, and specifically Peter. You guys remember Peter. Peter tried to walk on water. You remember Peter. Peter specifically comes, and he talks to Christ, and he says, listen. Christ says, I've got to go somewhere. And then Peter says, well, wherever you go, Christ, I can be with you. I can go with you. And Christ tells him, well, you can't. The problem is you will fail, you won't make it, and by the time the cock crows 3 times, you would have denied me. So that's where we're in our text, and now we pick it up, and then we're going to look at the promises of heaven. John 14, it reads as follows. It says, do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. He says, in my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, I would not have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and I will receive you to myself where I am that you may be also. And you're going to know the way where I am going. Now Thomas responded here. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going and we don't even know the way. And Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one comes to the Father but through me. There's a book called Heaven is for Real. In the book, it depicts a young boy that's about 4 years old. I think there's a movie about it as well. The boy has a surgery. During the surgery, he has complications. With those complications, he, for a moment, they said he had died and had been brought back to life. And when he had come back to life, he told his mother and father, he said, I've been to heaven. He told them, I went there, and heaven is for real. He said, when I got there, he talked about seeing his grandmother, his grandfather. He talked about seeing people that his dad would have known. He talked about all of that. And as he talked to his parents, he told them everything was fine when I got there. He said the place was fabulous. And he said they welcomed me in. And while he was talking to them, he says, Mom and Dad, I promise you, Mom and Dad, that heaven is for real. Right here in this text, I think we get the promises of heaven to let us know that heaven is for real. Because as we approach John chapter 14, he tells them, that's where I'm going. I'm going to heaven. That's where I'm going to set everything up and get ready for you. And he says, when I do, the promises of heaven, I'm going to tell you this, it starts that you will have a settled heart. How do I know that? Because in the very first verse, he says, don't let your heart be troubled. See, a broken heart. Their hearts were stirred. And how does the heart of men and women get stirred? Is from uncertainty and things you don't know. You're uncertain about what's going to happen. You don't know how things are going to turn out. And all of a sudden, we get anxiety. Those things come into our life. Our hearts are troubled. Our hearts have uncertainty. Our hearts have been stirred. And this is how they felt. They were sitting there, Christ telling them, I'm getting ready to leave. You can't go with me. And they're going, what's going to happen to us? How will life turn out? Oh, we have these uncertainties. And we have to deal with them. So how do we deal when our hearts are broken and our hearts have been distressed? And it seems like trouble is on the horizon. We try to medicate and self-medicate. We try to do different things to maybe even help that. And he tells them, he says, listen, let me tell you about the promises of heaven. Because when you get there, your heart will be settled. It's no longer stirred and troubled like a wind or a roaring flame. It's no longer that way. It's a heart now that has been settled. Why is the heart settled? What's different? He says, because trust comes in. What did he say in the verse? Believe in me. He says, if you believe in God, believe also in me. Trust. Trust settles it. A troubled heart settled by trust. He says, if you simply trust me, if you have trusted God, then he says, you can trust me. I wouldn't normally tell you to put your trust in men or trust in women. I wouldn't normally tell you to trust in anything, but I would tell you to trust Christ. He is a man that's different than any other man. He's the God man. 100% God, 100% man. But yet he tells them, trust me, believe in God, believe also in me. He said, that's what settles the heart. This is the promise he's giving them. You want your heart settled? Trust God. You want the anxiety gone? Trust God. You want the fear to leave? Trust God. He says, believe in God. Because when you do, all fear goes. He says, trouble cannot reside in the same arena as your trust in God. The two won't mix. He says, that's the answer. That's the antidote to a troubled heart. That's the promise he can lay out before us, is that our hearts would be settled. Believe in God. Also, believe in me. Little girl starts to go blind. 12 years old. She began to deteriorate with her eyes. She would go to school. She thought she was just simply clumsy. She said, because I would bump into things. I would miss steps. I would try to navigate the school, and I couldn't do it without hitting students and teachers. Come to find out, she was going blind. They changed her prescription on her eyeglasses. Helped some, but not always. She went to the doctor. Doctor gave her the news with her parents, 16 years old. Said, you're going blind, and there's nothing we can do. You will be blind. She has to ride home with her parents. They're driving the car. She's sitting in the back seat. In her heart, she said, I'm thinking about, will I ever get married? I'm thinking, will any boy like me? I'm thinking, will I have an opportunity to finish high school? She said on the drive, she was thinking whether or not she would get to go to college. Matter of fact, she said, I began to think as I looked down at my hands, will my hands have to learn to read Braille? She said, that's what I'm thinking in the car going home. Said, when they got home, in her story, she says she went to the piano. She began to play a song called It Is Well With My Soul. She played that. And she said, as she played, she said her heart began to settle. She said at that moment, she decided she was going to trust God for whatever the outcome was going to be. She said, that's what my life is going to be, but I'm going to trust God. So whatever happens, whatever may occur, I'm going to put all of my trust in a Savior who can save me. A promise of heaven. A settled heart. But not only that, it's a place to stay. How do I know? Verse 2. Text says, I go there and prepare a place just for you. Said it's a place you and I would want to stay. It's supposed to be a magnificent place. Matter of fact, a spacious place. We may run out of room in here, but you won't run out in heaven. It may not be enough seats in here, but there are plenty seats in heaven. He says, in my Father's house, there are many dwelling places, many places for you. Every one of us would have a place there. It would never run out. He says, I went to prepare the place, get it ready on your behalf. And he says, I'm preparing that place right now. For whoever wants to come, he says, I'm preparing a place, a room that has your name on it, specifically designed for you, just the way you like it, with all of the things you like. He says, I'm getting that ready, and it will be a place that you would want to stay. So if you ever get an opportunity, it's like, I would not want to leave because it's just that good. See, I had to, in the summer, go stay with my grandmother, grandfather. See, I don't even know if they do that nowadays. I don't know if they take their kids and let them stay with grandmama and granddaddy during the summer, but back when I was coming up, that was the deal. So you, my mama, you gotta learn to like it. Whether you like it, you better learn to like it. But I liked it. I wanted to go. You know why? I wanted to go because at our house, all of my brothers, we slept together. But at my big mama house, that was big mama, she was big mama to me. But at my big mama house, we got our own room. It was different. At my big mama house, it was all kinds of foods up in there. Peach preserve, apple pie. I was happy to go. It was different. And you know what? At my big mama house, every time we came, she would be standing at the door ready to welcome us in. Big hugs would be going around from big mama. As we come up through there, never wanted to see Big Daddy. He always wanted to spank you. Don't want to see him. He wanted to spank you. But Big Mama was nothing but love. That's all we got. And we'd want to stay even when the summer was over. Mama, can we stay with our grandmother? It was the place to be. That's what heaven's going to be like. It's going to be the place to be. A place you'd want to stay. A place that God is getting ready for you. A place that is spacious. A place with your own room. This is what it's going to be like. And he's going to be welcoming you in. Saying, come in. I've got everything ready. I've got everything prepared. I've been cleaning all day. The house is ready. Your room is ready. The food is prepared. And guess what? I'm standing to bring you in. That's going to be like Christ. The same way with us, a place to stay. Listen, I'm going to close. I'm not going to keep you long. And as I close, I'm going to tell you this last thing. It's a special way in.
This time I want y'all to help us do it. Lift your hands in this atmosphere and say, I am grateful. Have done. Look at him and tell him, yes, I'm grateful. The victories that we've won. Tell him I could go on and on. About your works. Because I'm grateful. Praise you, Lord. Lift your hands and say, flowing from my heart.
When warts get out.
You can just grab a hand. It's not too late. And let me pray for you. Heavenly Father, as we're here today, we just come with gratitude in our hearts. Thankful for these men and women. Thank you that all they've done in their lives. I pray, God, that you would watch over them. I pray, God, that you would give them everything that they could possibly need. I pray that you settle the troubled hearts with uncertainty and unknown. Pray, God, that you would bring us to a trust in you. I pray, God, that the promises of heaven are there. I pray that they're available to each and every one of us. I pray that it's a place that we'll find that's beautiful and worth seeing. I pray, God, that we know that the only way to get there is through you. I pray, God, that everyone here decided to be special. And to be special is to know you as their Lord and Savior. I pray that they drop every sin and we turn from our ways and we give our life to you. God, we thank you for the life of Leon. And if he was here today, he would stand with his arms open Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap.
I want to thank Pastor for his for the message. At this time, we're going to have a solo by Latasha Miller, solo song.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
All right, we need to liven up because he was not a child that was not lively and never didn't smile. So we need to perk up, as his grandmother that he loved so much would say. This song my mama used to make me sing, and I'm, oh my goodness. I'm like Root and Turner, Bobby Jean Miller, and I know he probably eating some greens and cabbage. I done missed that dry comb braid. So we need to celebrate his life. We don't need to moan. We need to celebrate. You know, because us as humans, as I told my brother, we are selfish people. We are selfish because we want others to hurt and stay so we can feel good. You know, we never know what other people are going through. That's the selfishness in us. So I'm going to sing their favorite song. They said I wouldn't make it. They said I wouldn't be here today. They said I never amount to anything. But I'm glad to say that I'm on my way, and I'm growing more and more each day. But now they're gone to stray.
Thank everyone for coming out. The next part of our program will be benediction and just a closing prayer. As I noticed everyone coming up and Pastor praying for everyone, I do want to take time to let the folks that came up who can come back and see us. Walking with Christ is much more than the one time you walk up and meet him. He wants a relationship with you that is taken day for day, hour for hour. We never know when the time will come and the world is coming down on you, crushing you in that hour. And you need to know him while he is to be found. In the moment the world comes down, if you don't know him, there may not be time. So come back and see us. We have a youth ministry dedicated to youth, ministering to youth where they are. We are not here to judge. We're here to minister to you and show you how to walk with Christ, no matter where you are in your life, no matter what you're doing, no matter how you feel. Come and see us. I look really good, and I have some nice things, but I've been through some things in life. There's some people in heaven that I want to see that have gone on before me, and I look forward. I don't have all of the despair of life because I know Jesus, and I know they're with Jesus, and I'll get to see them again. His mother said, when you see Leon again, ask him. Well, and if you want to see Leon again, you're going to have to know Jesus because he's the only way you're going to see him. I promise you that. Amen? Let us pray. Lord, we just commend our brother Leon to the mercy of God, our maker and our redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we acknowledge you and we humbly beseech you. He being a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, and a sinner of your own redeeming, we ask that you would just take him into your bosom and surround him with your peace. And finally, Heavenly Father, we pray desperately for ourselves that your grace and mercy will teach us how to go on living. Help us to bear the daily pain of our grief and sorrow. Give us the courage to reach out for help, to share our story, to admit our needs, and to pray when all we see is darkness and discouragement. Help us to remember that your love is the perfect remedy for all that grieves us. Guide us, help us, hold us. Grant daily strength and even hourly strength, Heavenly Father. Remind us to turn to you for all of our cares and to rest in your grace and mercy. We now say farewell and we commend our dear one to your loving arms. In the name of Jesus, our Savior, amen. Outside, we have food and refreshments. Please allow the family to go first. Thank you very much for coming. God bless.